Tyler Perry has offered to pay for all funeral expenses for Rayshard Brooks' funeral. Brooks was shot by an Atlanta police officer on Friday after officers responded to a call about a man sleeping in a car at a Wendy's restaurant drive-thru. Brooks was shot in the back and pronounced dead later at a hospital, according to authorities. His death had sparked protests in Atlanta.
Well, he was shot at three times, but two got into his back. Who shoots? Okay, well, Tyler Perry, I'm very happy he did that. It's one of those things that I don't know. I hope that there's some times when we get into the news for giving and things like that. I'm always very worried about giving that's not very sustainable, because you might want to help, but are you really helping? Is always what I think about in regards to everything. And this is one of those ones where absolutely people need healing, and they are deserving of a befitting funeral so that everyone can come together, especially families. He's just popular. There's a lot of families that have lost people today, yesterday, that are just not filmed, and they can all come together and have that space and everything, and that's amazing. But I hope that it doesn't stop there in regards to, because I looked at that woman when she was talking, carrying her baby, and I was just thinking, the odds that you already have to face because you're a black person, a black woman, and you've now lost a provider. And he did really well in providing for his family, as far as, you know, her statement and everything. I hope that people come together and help, like the way Kanye gave. Yeah. Where he set up funds and things that are sustainable. So I hope that they're also thinking about that. But yeah, kudos to Tyler.
I think for me, it's just, once again, very interesting. It reminds me of, I don't know if it was the Ghanaian singer, the Wendy Shea, that was talking about black on black crime when people were talking about racism. And it's like, it's really not the same.
No, it's not.
Because the truth is, whether you like it or not, the police is there to protect. It's supposed to be there to protect people. And when you have the police killing people, it doesn't make any sense, whether in any country, whether it is Nigeria or the United States of America, it makes no sense. And I watched the video of this young man. He was smiling. Of course, clearly he was drunk. He was not sober. And of course, he failed the sobriety test. But that is not an excuse.
But we don't even know. He didn't say. He didn't actually.
He failed the test.
He failed the test, according to the news. He failed the test. But I'm like, it still doesn't mean. He was sleeping. He wasn't drunk. He wasn't drunk driving. So on what basis did they have to arrest him in the first place? And even if he tried to run away, it's still not an excuse for him to die. I mean, this is the situation that black people have to face in America. The fact that you can wake up one morning and go out.
I like a good example.
Take that a drink,
somebody
and then
said
not going to come
when
back
you
home.
Mentioned that in regards to black on black violence against white killing brutality, someone said, okay, so imagine you saying that, why are you complaining that a few doctors are deliberately killing their patients when people come into the room to the hospital every day and die on their own anyway? That's kind of like
the same
comparison
the
between
kind of
black people. But it's I'm exhausted from.
I think the conversation is really police brutality, and now it is more
police brutality based on race.
So it is. I think it's a broad conversation, and if you're not careful, you might miss the point, which is what some people are actually doing when they begin to bring out other issues that we know, yes, they are there, but that's not the point right now.
Exactly.
We know someone has been killed unjustly, regardless whether he was drunk, whatever. Your job is to protect, not to kill the people you are supposed to protect. And talking about sustainable giving, as much as we need that, and I hope that people can rally around to get that for the family, there are givings that actually take away burdens and help you mourn right and help you feel right, you know. And I think that is what Tyler Perry's giving is doing right now. There would be conversations for the future and what can be done for the wife and the child and all that, but right now there is an immediate need. And I think it's a global culture now for people to rally around when someone dies to give the person a befitting burial. But going forward, I hope that that conversation will come up as well to ensure that the family is well taken care of.
And I also think it's very important for people to note that even as people are rioting, they're still killing black people. So I've seen some people say, oh, the protest should be over already. Why are people still protesting? Well, we are still protesting. Or they are still protesting. Happening. Because it is still happening.
And I think
a young girl lost her life recently.
I want to hope that someone like Trump, because I was watching the news this morning and he was talking about them sending the National Guard and all. And I'm really hoping that he can have a change of heart and the correct brain to know that the conversation, he should really hit the nail on the head and address the issue. Not just forgetting about why what is happening is happening, and focusing on the facts that you think there is disruption and people
are burning things.
You know, like, why not tackle it from the roots?
You know how crazy it is when he wants to go and address people who are really hurt, and then he sends military first to go before him. Throw tear gases in people's houses just so that he can come.
I mean, I'm a fan of Donald Trump. It's not like fan, but there are things that he does that it just makes me laugh. And I see humor in it, but the way he's been handling this Black Lives Matter protest is just very distasteful. And I hope that he thinks someone speaks to him and gets him to do the right
thing.
And
people should even realize that no matter how many buildings are burned, it is not the same as somebody's life. Somebody's parents died, somebody's brother died, somebody's sister died. I don't care if they born or buildings. I don't care. Buildings can be replaced. That person's life would never
and
be replaced.
And I think people are also, people, especially in Nigeria, and I guess that's also just a bit of ignorance there, that I think people are forgetting that burning buildings is a historically American thing. So that's how they actually communicate a lot of the times. And white people started that thing when they have a problem with either the locals or the newly freed bread, the slaves and everything. They'll go to their houses, their buildings, burn their churches, burn their schools. They started this burning thing. So sometimes I think you hear some people say, well, why are they burning now?
I support the Black Lives Matter movement, but please, they stop burning things.
Burning is very American.